As we age, we lose muscle mass. This is called sarcopenia. If we take a look at the thigh of a younger adult, we see that the muscles occupy almost all space. And here in the middle, there is the bone. Now, if we look at the thigh of a 70-year-old person of the same weight and height, this is what we see. Most of the space is occupied by fat tissue, and the muscles are reduced in size. The consequences of sarcopenia can be devastating, like increased risk of falls, reduced physical capacity, disability, depression, less participation in social activities and enjoyment of life. So today I'll answer some common questions that people ask me about sarcopenia. How can I tell if I have sarcopenia? How is sarcopenia diagnosed? Can we prevent sarcopenia? Once it happens, can we revert sarcopenia and build up muscles like the younger versions of ourselves? What treatments are available for sarcopenia? How can I support a loved one with sarcopenia? So let's talk about sarcopenia today. In 2016, sarcopenia has been officially recognized as a disease by the International Classification of Diseases, or ICD version 10. It is a condition of loss of muscle mass and function with age. The world population is getting older and older, which is a fabulous thing, but then more people are seeking medical care because of the consequences of sarcopenia. One of the first signs of sarcopenia is a noticeable decline in muscle strength. However, sarcopenia happens little by little, so the person may not notice right away. But if they compare their strength to 10 years ago, they may remember that doing certain activities was easy and now it's becoming difficult, like carrying the laundry load upstairs. The person never had any difficulty doing that, now they can't do anymore, or they can do it, but it requires a lot of effort and they get very tired. They may also have difficulty lifting objects, climbing stairs, getting up from a seated position. Another way of checking for sarcopenia is testing for weakness in the hands with a grip strength or being able to hold objects securely. The second sign of sarcopenia is fatigue. The person will feel exhaustion, even during routine activities that were once manageable. They will feel a general sense of tiredness, or they may feel specific muscles tired during tasks that require repetitive movements, like making a bread, gardening, washing the car, or pushing a shopping cart. Fatigue really impacts their ability to participate in daily activities with energy and enthusiasm, so they avoid social interactions. The third sign that the person has sarcopenia is a diminished physical performance. This can manifest in poor coordination, balance, and mobility issues. They will notice that they can't maintain their balance while walking or standing. They can't bend, reach, or turn anymore. These activities become challenging to perform with ease and precision. The fourth sign that the person has sarcopenia is their body shape. It is often noticeable and includes loss of muscle mass and replacement by body fat. They notice a loss of muscle bulk, particularly in the arms, legs, and abdomen. It gives them an appearance of frailty or less toned. It is common also to accumulate fat tissue, which can make the sense of fatigue and weakness even worse. Can a doctor diagnose sarcopenia? Is there any test that can be ordered? Healthcare professionals in some specialties like physiatry, neurology, geriatrics medicine, rheumatology, are able to say if the person has sarcopenia doing a physical assessment. They will look at the body composition, look for muscle wasting or weakness, assess posture and gait, and they may measure waist circumference and calculate a body mass index or BMI. Normally, it's not necessary to order imaging studies or blood tests. A physiotherapist or occupational therapist can be involved in more severe cases, and they can do specific muscle strength tests using a dynamometer, which measures the grip strength. They can also assess specific tasks like chair stands, get up and walk tests, leg press, and other activities that may impact a person's functionability. If we suspect that the person may have osteoporosis, we may order a bone density study, but those studies are specific to the bones, not to the muscles. The healthcare professional will also assess the person for any risk factors that could be accelerating the sarcopenia, things like medications, mental health, dietary intake, use of alcohol, presence of diabetes, chronic infections, and thyroid problems. I prepared a summary for you that contains all the information in this video. Go to the description of this video below. There is a link for you to download this free summary. Can sarcopenia be prevented? Yes, absolutely. Sarcopenia can be slowed down using a variety of lifestyle modifications and interventions. You may find many seniors on the internet, on social media, YouTube, who are examples of what I'm talking about. They are in their 70s, 80s, 90s, and even in their 100s, and they have minimal sarcopenia. Their bodies are capable of doing things that many younger individuals in their 30s or 40s cannot do. They have minimal pain, and they can tell you that if pain affects them, they are ready to take charge of their body. These older adults, when they get sick, like if they have an injury, a disease, and they end up in hospitals, they're the ones who recover faster and survive longer. Anyone who is hospitalized for a few weeks will lose muscle mass. We all do. It's a natural process. However, if we get two seniors, same age, same weight, same height, same gender, one has sarcopenia, the other don't, guess who will lose less muscle mass during hospitalization and will recover faster? Yes. The person who has more muscle mass at baseline will have a better chance of survival and quality of life after hospitalization. So think about this. You need to be in good shape to get sick. On sunny days, you prepare for the rainy days. Before I continue, let me remind you that this video is not medical advice. The intent is for educational purposes only. If you suspect you have a medical condition like sarcopenia, please talk to your doctor or ask your physiotherapist. And if there is an emergency, please call an ambulance or go to the nearest emergency department. We know that the person has the maximum muscle mass in early adulthood, in their 20s, and they keep these muscles until they reach 40 years of age, and then sarcopenia takes over. And there is a substantial decline that starts in their fifth decade. Sarcopenia is a normal consequence of aging, however, it was recognized as a disease in 2016, mainly due to the fact that it can be prevented and treated. Okay, so let's go back to the question, how can we prevent sarcopenia? Here are 5 tips for anyone who is entering their 40s. First, regular exercises, especially resistance training. Engaging in regular physical activity, particularly resistance training or strength training exercises, is essential for preventing sarcopenia. Resistance training involves using weights, resistance bands, or body weight exercises to challenge the muscles and stimulate growth. This type of exercise helps increase muscle mass, strength, and endurance, reducing the risks of muscle loss associated with aging. 2. Maintain an adequate protein intake. Protein is the building block of muscle tissue, and insufficient intake can contribute to muscle loss over time. Older adults should aim to include high-quality protein sources in their diet, such as lean meats, poultry, fish, eggs, dairy products, legumes, nuts, and seeds. There is not a lot of consensus from the scientific literature about how much protein a person needs to avoid muscle loss due to aging. A good recommendation is around 1.6 to 1.8 grams of protein per kilogram of body weight per day. So, if the person weighs 60 kilograms, they need 96 to 108 grams of protein per day. This can be animal sources of protein like eggs, milk, meat, fish, poultry, or processed sources like animal protein like whey and casein. There are many sources of plant-based proteins like soy, beans, peanuts, nuts, seeds, and wheat. It's really important to consult your physician, especially if you have a chronic kidney disease or liver disease. In these cases, the person may be limited to the amount of protein they can ingest per day. 3. Avoid a sedentary lifestyle. It's essential to avoid prolonged sitting and incorporate regular physical activity into daily routines. Even light to moderate activities such as walking, gardening, or household chores can help maintain muscle mass and mobility. Aim for at least 150 minutes of moderate intensity aerobic activity or 75 minutes of vigorous intensity activity each week, along with muscle strengthening activities on 2 or more days per week. Fourth, stay hydrated. Dehydrating can impair muscle performance and recovery, making it harder to maintain muscle mass and strength. Older adults should aim to drink an adequate amount of fluids throughout the day, focusing on water and other hydrating beverages such as herbal teas, infused water, and low-sugar electrolyte drinks. Fifth, get sufficient sleep. Quality sleep is crucial for muscle recovery and repair. During sleep, the body undergoes essential processes that help rebuild and regenerate muscle tissue. Chronic sleep deprivation or poor sleep quality can interfere with these processes and contribute to muscle loss over time. Aim for 7 to 9 hours of quality sleep per night to support optimal muscle health and overall well-being. Now, the next question is very interesting. Once it happens, can we revert sarcopenia and build up muscles like our younger versions of ourselves? We know that sarcopenia is a disease. It has been recognized by the International Classification of Disease, or ICD-10, in 2016. But how do we treat it? Is there any medication? Well, because we still do not fully understand how sarcopenia happens, it's hard to develop a treatment, most specifically a drug that reverts that. There are some targets for drugs that the pharmaceutical industry is trying to develop. They include the following: myostatin. This is a substance found in the muscles that inhibits muscle cell growth. There are some drugs in development that inhibit myostatin. One of them is called istamulubab. Another one is called lendogrozumab. And another one is called trevogrumab, which is an antibody against the myostatin. Another drug in study is ramatercept. These drugs are being tested in children who have a genetic form of muscle dystrophy. Another target for sarcopenia is the activin receptor. One drug that is being developed is bimagrumab. But we don't have any conclusive results yet. There are also drugs that try to produce the same benefits of exercises. They would be like exercises pills. That would be good for those people who cannot do exercises for some reason, like a nerve injury or a paralysis. But we don't have any drugs yet. Metformin, a drug commonly used to treat diabetes type 2, has some effects on muscles, but its effects on sarcopenia is still under debate. Hormones like testosterone or anabolic steroids have been studied in some clinical trials. But there were side effects, and especially in women, developed some male-related body changes. So, once the person is diagnosed with sarcopenia, currently the treatment involves the same things that we mentioned to prevent sarcopenia. And they are exercise programs, nutrition with high protein intake, avoid the sedentary lifestyle, hydration, and quality sleep. If you like this video so far, subscribe to this channel and turn on the notifications button so you will be alerted when I post new videos here. And finally, how can you support a loved one who is demonstrating sarcopenia? Supporting a loved one with sarcopenia involves offering practical assistance, encouragement, and emotional support to help them manage the condition and maintain their overall well-being. Here are some tips for family members or caregivers. First, encourage your loved one to engage in regular physical activity, particularly exercise that focus on building and maintaining muscle strength, such as resistance training. Offer to accompany them on walks, attend exercise classes together, or participate in activities that they enjoy. Providing companionship and motivation can help them stay consistent with their exercise routine. 2. Offer assistance with everyday tasks that may become challenging due to muscle weakness and fatigue. This could include household chores, grocery shopping, meal preparation or transportation to medical appointments. Providing practical support can alleviate stress and help your loved one conserve energy for activities they enjoy. Third, ensure that your loved one is following a balanced diet that includes adequate protein, vitamins, and minerals to support muscle health. Offer to help plan and prepare nutritious meals together and encourage them to stay hydrated throughout the day. Consider consulting a registered dietitian for personalized dietary recommendations based on their individual needs and preferences. 4. Provide emotional support. Listen attentively to your loved one's concerns and feelings about living with sarcopenia. Offer empathy, validation, and reassurance, and let them know that you are there to support them every step of the way. Encourage open communication and provide a safe space for them to express their emotions without judgment. 5. Offer encouragement and motivation. Offer words of encouragement and praise for their efforts to maintain an active lifestyle and adhere to their treatment plan. Celebrate their achievements, no matter how small, and remind them of the progress they've made. Encourage a positive mindset and focus on their strengths and abilities rather than their limitations. 6. Facilitate social connections. Encourage your loved one to stay socially engaged and connected with friends, family, and community activities. Arrange social outings, invite friends over for visits, or participate in group activities or clubs that align with their interests. Social support and meaningful connections can contribute to overall well-being and mental health. 7. And finally, educate yourself about sarcopenia. Take the time to learn more about sarcopenia, its causes, symptoms, and management strategies. Stay informed about the latest research and treatment options, and communicate openly with healthcare providers to advocate for your loved one's needs and preferences. Now it's your turn to answer a question. Write the answer in the comments box below. What is your experience with sarcopenia? Write a comment that will help other people who are struggling with sarcopenia. And thank you for watching today. Goodbye.